we were going to see him against one of the top contact guys in the American League. This guy, he likes to put it in play. Stephen Kwan, he's leading the majors, hitting 352, and he's the first man that Skeens will face. It's highly anticipated all-star start. First pitch, pops it up, back and out of play. This is a really good American League lineup that Kwan leads off. And he's got a few MVP candidates to follow, Henderson, Soto, and Judge. I think the world would love to see Skeens against Judge in this first inning. Alvarez gets to play in an all-star game for the first time. Jose Ramirez, his sixth appearance. Guerrero, Rutschman, and Simeon. Strickland 0-2 on Kwan. He's got great glove side command. In other words, into a lefty, away to a righty. But then you see the fading action there of the two-seamer and changeup. And his ability is off the charts. And he could literally throw all four-seam fastballs. I was hoping we'd see more of them, because it's an angle that not a lot of people see. You see the 89 strikeouts through his first 11 career starts. Pittsburgh's going to have to find a way to get him through the second half. And can you imagine them in the postseason?
Oh, man.
There's that four-seamer at 100 miles per hour. Popped into shallow center field. And an easy one for Trey Turner. But first out at 6'6 with his arm angle and his ability to repeat his mechanics. Of course, that four-seam fastball is unlike some other four-seam fastballs. And then you couple that with his ability to go to both sides of the plate. Man, he is electric and showing off at Pittsburgh.
This is a guy who won Rookie of the Year last year and is an MVP candidate this season, Gunnar Henderson. Skeens comes home and gets strike one. One-of-a-kind pitcher and a one-of-a-kind path to the big leagues for Skeens. Now, his first dream was to be a fighter pilot. So Paul starts his college career at the Air Force Academy. Gets his fastball by him, and it's 0-2. On the baseball field, he's much more of a catcher than he is a pitcher at first. So we're not saying he just goes up there and does a little catch. Oh, he hit above 400 as a freshman. But the more he pitches, the more he dominates. The more he dominates, the more he starts to think, okay, maybe there's something to chasing this baseball dream. And so he makes what he says is the hardest decision he's ever had to make. And he leaves the academy for LSU. He becomes the first pick 1 year later. And now 2 years after he's flying fighter jets, he's pitching in the All-Star game. His 1-2 to Henderson. Is tapped in front of the plate. Cadet hops off of the mound and fires it down there in round number two.
Oh, he's throwing fuel. He might have been burning fuel up in the air. He's throwing fuel. And again, the key is going to keep him healthy through the second half as the Pirates are close enough in a playoff spot. And, man, it's just fun to watch him pitch and dominate.
11 starts in, still perfect at 6-0, coming off his best one yet. 7 no-hit innings against the Brewers last week. And his first one to Juan Soto draws the kind of swing that nobody draws against this generational hitter in Soto.
It's kind of like a split-finger sinker, right? That ball just at 94, by the way, drops out. That's the one pitch that has the ability to upgrade. That's the one he can get on the side of, the slider. It's going to be a weapon for him. But I would think that if that upgrade continues as normal pitchers do, he is going to be unhittable.
There he is. Part of a power couple, part of an LSU power couple that's become kind of a pop culture power couple. His girlfriend is LSU gymnast, social media star Libby Dunn. Swing and a miss, 2-2.
See, right here, selfishly, I want to see a four-seam fastball. I don't know that that's where it'll go, but I'd love to see it. 2-2, mano-a-mano, go after one of the best in Soto. He hasn't seen it yet. I wonder if they'll go with that four-seam fastball here up in the zone.
Well, you've seen 100 with that four-seam in this first inning. It's 2-2 on Soto. Skeens looking for a 1-2-3 All-Star debut. It is straight up and out of play.
And with the four-seam fastball, he caught a little bit of the middle of the plate. Up above would have been tough. This is one of the best in the game at controlling the strike zone with his bat.
And one of the best in baseball against high heat. Both these guys, if he's able to get Judge to the plate. That that's outside. I know you want to see it for me. You know what I want to see? What everybody wants to see? Soto's got to reach base so you can see his
team. That's come on, give the people what they want.
Well, Soto reaches base a lot.
He sure does.
And they asked him yesterday, well, you know, we got to get Judge to the plate. He said, don't worry, I'll make sure he hits. And he won the line. There's ball four. And he points to Judge and says, I got you, big fella. Here's the matchup that folks are dreaming of. Paul Skeens against Aaron Judge.
I think they crossed him.
Okay, I'm going to struggle. They crossed him. Baseball gods did it. Look at this pitch. He throws it right there and just missed it. These two obviously doing a lot. Chops the first one that he sees down the ball and they're going to short one and finish up this inning. We got to see it. The Skeens made a short visit. Libby loves it. And America probably starting to love this guy right here.